name is Pastor Ikechukwu Chinedum, and I'm your host on Everyday Prayer Guide Television. Today, we shall be engaging in intercessory prayers, and our focus is on prayers for church members. Prayers for church members. If you are new to this channel, I encourage you to subscribe so that your spiritual life can be on fire. This is a powerful prayer channel, and all we do every day is to pray for issues that concern the life of people all around the world. So I encourage you to subscribe and join us on our prayers. And as you do, the God of heaven shall give you testimonies in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Prayers for church members is our intercessory prayer focus for today. It's important for you and I to know that a church is not the building. A church is the people. A church is not the building you see. You know, some people just say, this is our church. They're pointing to a building. No, the church is a living organism, a living organization, and it comprises of the saints. It comprises of the saints. And Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18 encourages us. It says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. For all saints. As a pastor, as an evangelist, as a matured Christian, praying for your members is a great thing to do. Praying for your members, praying intercessory prayers for your members is a great thing to do. Intercessory prayers is a major and a more potent kind of prayer. That's what most people don't know. Most people are always focused on praying for themselves. I want to pray for myself. I want to pray for my needs. You know, economics tells us that the wants of man is insatiable. When you are praying for your needs, you always pray for your needs. But when you begin to pray for others, the Bible said, the liberal man shall be made fat. He that watereth others shall himself be watered. When you are an intercessor, when you are praying for the needs of others, God is busy meeting your needs. God is busy meeting your needs. Any pastor that want to see growth in his church should spend time, quality time, to pray for the members. To pray for the members. If you want to see quality growth in your church, if you want to see things happen in the lives of the people, if you want to see massive salvation, if you want to see business breakthroughs, if you want to see miracles everywhere, if you want to see signs and wonders, if you want to see supernatural turnaround, mega testimonies, you must be giving to intercessory prayers for your members. You must mention their needs before the Lord. You must say, oh God, bless these people. Oh God, turn their story around. Oh God, visit them. Unfortunately, many pastors, not all though, many pastors, are interested in what they can get from their members. They are interested in bread and butter. They are interested, they are not paying enough tithes. They are not paying offerings. You know, they are stingy. Like some pastors will say, my members are stingy. Man, you are not doing enough. You are the one that is supposed to do your spiritual part by praying for them. And in turn, when they are blessed, you don't need to encourage a blessed man to give. Even a stingy man, when he gets what he or she is looking for, he will give. She will give. If not for anything to show that he or she is a big boy, they will bless you. So, first of all, focus on blessing them. Focus on what? Blessing them. Listen, God told Abraham in Genesis chapter 12, he said, I will bless you, I will make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. God first of all said to Abraham, I will bless you and make you great. Then you can now be a blessing. That is your heart as a pastor to your members. First of all, you will bless them. You will make them great. And after which, they will become a blessing to you and to others. You should be a blesser conscious. You should be blessing conscious, not being blessed conscious. You should be being a blessing conscious pastor. You have to be a blessing conscious believer, a blessing conscious matured Christian, not a being blessed conscious. Not, my members need to bless me. No, you need to bless them first. And how do you bless your members? It is through intercessory prayers. It is through praying for them. It is through interceding for them. Praying for your church members. Praying for their well-being. Praying that God should visit them. Praying for those that don't have a job, for God to give them miracle jobs. For those that don't have children and they are believing God for children, that God should visit them as He visited Anna and Sarah. Pray for those that are having crisis in their family for the storm to pass. Pray for broken homes to come back together. Pray for them. And I trust God that as we pray this prayer this morning, every challenge in your church, every challenge in the life of the members of your church, God shall turn into a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. God shall turn into a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. These prayers are focused on the all-round well-being of the church members. Intercessory prayers for church members this morning, they are focused on the all-round well-being for the church members. When the members of a church is healthy, the church is healthy. When the member of the church is rich, the church is rich. When the member of the church is spiritually robust, the church is spiritually robust. When the members of the church, on the other hand, is broke, the church is broke. When your members are poor, your church is poor. When your members are spiritually down, the church is spiritually down. So you see, prayers for members is the fuel that fires up the success of your church. And I trust God that as we join faith together and pray, you shall see strange order of success in your ministry in the mighty name of Jesus. You shall see strange order of success in your ministry in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus spent a lot of time praying for his disciples, 12 of them, and the rest. He spent a lot of time praying for them. At one time, he told Peter, he said, the devil has targeted you to sift you like wheat. He said, but I have prayed for you. He said, when thou art strengthened, pray for others. He said, strengthen others. When I have stood, strengthen others. In other words, as I have prayed for you, when you have stood your ground, pray for others. Pray for others. If you see John chapter 17, 1 to 26, Jesus dedicated that whole place, that whole verse, from verse 1 to 26, praying for his disciples. Praying for his disciples. In Ephesians chapter 1, 16 to 23, you see Paul praying for the Ephesian church. Praying for the Ephesian church. You never see Paul pray for himself. You never see Jesus pray for himself. You never see these people pray for themselves. Mature Christians understand that praying for others is the secret. You never see Jesus praying for himself. You never see the apostles pray for themselves. They were busy praying for the well-being of the church. And they lacked nothing. They lacked nothing. Because there is no how you are watering others and you lack water. So I want to encourage you watching this video now. Make intercessory prayers a major thing in your life. Start praying more for others. Whatsoever you need, there are millions of people that need it. Start to pray for them and you see God show up in your life. You have been praying personal prayers, personal supplication for many years. Try intercessory prayers. Try to pray for others. Try to pray for others and see the God of heaven show up on your behalf in the name of Jesus. I believe you are ready to pray this morning. Lift up your voice to heaven and begin to appreciate the Lord. Father, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. You alone are God. You alone are God. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name alone should be praised. Father, we bless your name. Jesus, we adore you. Ancient of Days, we magnify you. Take all the glory. Take all the honor. Take all adoration. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Now, prayer one. We are engaging in intercessory prayers, and our focus is on prayers for church members. Prayer one. Father, in the name of Jesus and by the Holy Ghost, empower every member of this church with supernatural wisdom, thereby resulting in noiseless breakthroughs in the name of Jesus. Now hear that prayer again. Father, empower every member of this church with supernatural wisdom, thereby resulting in noiseless breakthroughs. Now lift up your voice and pray that prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus and by the Holy Ghost, empower every member of my church, or this church, you have mentioned the name of your church, with supernatural wisdom, thereby resulting in noiseless breakthrough. Father, empower every member of this church by the power of the Holy Ghost. Empower them with supernatural wisdom, the kind that will lead to noiseless breakthroughs. Empower them, Lord. Empower them, Lord. Every member of this church with supernatural wisdom, the kind that will lead to noiseless breakthroughs. Empower, Lord. Empower every member of this church with supernatural wisdom, the kind that will lead to noiseless breakthroughs. Empower every member of this church with supernatural wisdom, the kind that will lead to noiseless breakthroughs. Empower, O Lord. Empower, O Lord, all every member with supernatural wisdom, the kind that will lead to noiseless breakthroughs. Empower, Lord. Empower, Lord, every member of our church with supernatural wisdom that will lead them to noiseless breakthroughs. Father, in the name of Jesus and by the Holy Ghost, empower every member of our church with supernatural wisdom that will lead to noiseless breakthrough. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. Prayer 2. Father, in the name of Jesus, endue every member of this church with the spirit of excellence for their supernatural turnaround. Are you hearing that prayer? Father, endue every member of this church with the spirit of excellence for their supernatural turnaround. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer. Father, endue every member of this church with the spirit of excellence, with the spirit of excellence, with the spirit of excellence that will lead to supernatural turnaround in your life. Endue every member of our church, endue every member of our church with the spirit of excellence that will lead to supernatural turnarounds in their lives. Lord, endue every member of this church with the spirit of excellence that will lead to supernatural turnaround in their life. Father, endue every member of this church with the spirit of excellence that will lead to supernatural turnaround in their life. Father, endue every member of this church with the spirit of excellence that will lead to supernatural turnaround in their life. Endue every member, Lord, of our church with the spirit of excellence that will lead to supernatural turnaround in their life. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Prayer 3. Father, in the name of Jesus, endue every member of this church with the spirit of grace and supplication, thereby positioning them for full delivery of their testimonies. Endue every member of our church with the spirit of grace and supplication, with the spirit of grace and supplication, thereby empowering them for their testimonies this year. Lord, let your spirit of grace rest upon every member. Let your spirit of supplication rest upon every member so that they can pray their way to their testimonies this year. Lord, let your spirit of grace and supplication rest upon every member of our church so that they can pray their way to the point of answers, so that they can pray their way to the point of testimonies. Lord, let your spirit of grace and supplication rest upon every member of our church. Let them pray their way to success. Let them pray their way to testimonies. In the name of Jesus, let the spirit of grace and supplication rest upon every member of this church. Let them pray their way to their testimonies. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer 4. Father, in the name of Jesus, fill every member of this church with the spirit of the fear of the Lord. Hallelujah. Fill every member of our church, Lord, with the spirit of the fear of the Lord. Let there be holiness in this church. Let there be holiness in this church. Lord, put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in every member of our church, in every man, in every woman, in every boy, in every girl, in every teenager. Lord, put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in their heart. Put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in their heart. Let righteousness reign in this church. Let holiness reign in this church. Let purity reign in this church. Put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in the heart of every member. Put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in the heart of every member. Let us walk in your ways. Let us think your thoughts. Let us do your deeds. In the name of Jesus. Father, put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in the life of every member. Put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in the life of every member. Father, in the name of Jesus, put the spirit of the fear of the Lord in the life of every member. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer 5. Prayer 5. Father, in the name of Jesus and by the Holy Ghost, let every member of this church be liberated from all filthiness of the flesh. and of the Spirit this year. Lord, let every member of this church be liberated, be set free from every filthiness of the flesh, for every filthiness of the body, from every filthiness of the spirit, from every filthiness of the soul. Liberate our members, liberate our members, liberate our members from every unholiness of the flesh, every unholiness of the body, every unholiness of the soul. Lord, liberate every member of this church from the filthiness of the flesh, from the lust of the flesh, from the lust of the eyes, from the pride of life. Lord, liberate them, liberate them, liberate them from every filthiness of the body, every filthiness of the soul, every filthiness of the flesh. Jesus, liberate them by your hand, by your mighty hand, liberate them. Regada basozo prima katale, eko kalamaya katozo, zigregadaya makalia, ekrokodosa kala, lekuza katalia. Lord, liberate every member of this church from the filthiness of the flesh, the filthiness of the body, the filthiness of the soul, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer 6. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every barrier standing in the way of the return of every challenged member of this church be brought down this year. Lord, every of our members that have left the church because of challenges, Lord, let whatever barrier holding them from coming back be destroyed. Let whatever barrier holding them from coming back be destroyed. Lord, visit them so that they will come back. Visit them so that they will come back. All our members that were challenged, and because of their challenge, they left the church. Lord, visit them. Visit them. Visit them and bring them back. Visit them and bring them back. Visit them, Lord, and bring them back. Visit them, Lord, and bring them back. Whatever made them to leave, Lord, Lord, deal with it. Deal with that situation. Deal with that situation. If it's a desire, Lord, grant them that desire. Whatever it is that had discouraged them, Lord, encourage them by granting them their testimonies. Encourage them by granting them their testimony. Lord, whatever barrier that is holding them from coming back to church, I destroy it. I destroy it. If it's a barrier of sin, is it a barrier of an unbeliever, is it a barrier of an evil influence, I scatter it now. I scatter it now. And I call them forth back to this church. I call them back to church. I call them back to church. I call them back to church now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. In the name of Jesus. Prayer 7. Father, in the name of Jesus, and by the Holy Ghost, redirect the steps of every embattled member back to this church. In the name of Jesus, Father, redirect the steps. Redirect the steps of every embattled member of this church back to this church. In the name of Jesus, Lord, as many of our members that have faced battles and the battles have taken them away from your house, Lord, redirect their steps. Redirect steps. Redirect their steps. In the name of Jesus, like the prodigal son, let them come back to themselves and come back to you. Lord, redirect their steps. Redirect their steps. Redirect their steps. Lord, do not replace them. Do not replace them. Bring them back. Bring them back. Bring them back. In the name of Jesus, redirect their steps. Forgive them. Lord, forgive them, Lord, for their faith could not carry the challenges. Lord, redirect their steps. Redirect their steps. Redirect their steps. Redirect their steps back to church. In the name of Jesus, Rekato Zekato, Lebre Makatalo, Zigarada Ma. Lekushaga, visit them, Lord, and redirect their step back to church in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer 8. Father, in the name of Jesus, let your angels appear to every embattled member, thereby guiding them back to church for their restoration and breakthrough. In the name of Jesus, Lord, let your angels be released right now to all embattled members of our church, redirecting them. Let your angels appear to them in dreams and in visions, redirecting them back to this church for their own breakthrough. Lord, as many as left the church due to one reason or the other, let your angels visit them en masse today and appear to them in dreams and in visions, redirecting them back to church, just as the angel of the Lord visited Cornelius and directed him to Peter. Let the angel of the Lord visit these members one after the other, redirecting them back to this church for their own breakthrough, for their own package, for their own breakthrough, for their own package. Lord, redirect them. Redirect them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, visit every discouraged member of this church, thereby reestablishing them in their faith. In the name of Jesus, Father, every discouraged member, every discouraged member in this church, Lord, visit them. Visit them. Change their story around. Lord, change their story around. Visit them and let their story be changed in the name of Jesus, thereby bringing them back to church. Lord, visit every discouraged member of this church. Visit every discouraged member, whatsoever has discouraged them. Lord, visit them. And Lord, redirect them by virtue of your testimonies in their lives. Lord, visit them, grant them their heart desire, change their story, and bring them back to church. Visit them, grant them their heart desire, change their story, and bring them back to church. Visit them, grant them their heart desire, change their stories, and bring them back to church. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer 10. Father, in the name of Jesus, open the eyes of every discouraged member to see this church as their God-ordained city of refuge. Lord, open the eyes of every member of this church to see this church as their God-ordained city of refuge. Lord, open their eyes. Lord, open their eyes to see that it is in you that their testimony is. It's in your hand that they can get their testimony. Lord, open your eyes. Open their eyes to see. Open their eyes to see that it is only in God that their salvation is, and thereby bringing them back to the house of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus, open their eyes to see, and thereby bringing them back to the house of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to pray right now. Lord, every member of this church is blessed. Begin to pour blessing upon your members. Every member of this church is blessed. Lord, their families are blessed. Their children are blessed. Their businesses are blessed. Their careers are blessed. Those that are looking for the fruit of the womb, they shall carry their children this year. Those that are believing God for miracle job, Lord, there shall be harvest of miracle jobs. Those that are believing God for turnaround, there shall be harvest of turnarounds. Those that are having family crisis, that storm is gone. In the name of Jesus, everyone that is spiritually down, I speak life into their spirit. In the name of Jesus, everyone struggling with one sin or the other, receive your deliverance now. Receive your deliverance now. In the name of Jesus, oh, my members are blessed. Our church members are blessed. God is visiting them one after the other at the same time. In the name of Jesus, Father, we give you praise. Father, we thank you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we give you praise. It is done in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm happy that we have prayed this prayer for our church members. And I trust God that these intercessory prayers will be made manifest in their lives in the name of Jesus. If you're a pastor watching this, your church shall know no decrease forever in the name of Jesus. It shall be from one level of growth to another level of growth in the name of Jesus. Effortless growth. Your members will be sharing mega testimonies. And God is going to take you places in Jesus' great name. We pray. Amen. I want to encourage you again. Subscribe to this channel. Be a part of what God is doing here. Join us every day as we pray. As we pray. And the God of heaven will keep visiting you in the mighty name of Jesus. If you want to get these prayers we just prayed now, just go to the description section below this video. You see all the prayers and more of those prayers in the name of Jesus. Also, I want to encourage you to visit our website, everydayprayerguide.com. It's a powerful website. It is the largest fire for fire prayer website on the internet. We have hundreds of thousands of prayer points addressing tens of thousands of issues. You need it, sir. As a Christian, every Christian in the world needs everydayprayerguide.com as part of their, you know, weaponry, spiritual weaponry for warfare as they run the race of life. Also, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and other social media network that is appearing on your screen. Hallelujah. Like this video, comment, and share it with your friends and families as your own way of being a blessing. God bless you. I still remain Pastor Ikechukwu Chinedum, your host at everydayprayerguide.com. See you at the top. You are blessed.